This open row of lavatories was described in the government commission report as the most disgraceful they'd ever seen. The hospital, they said, had an air of stagnation and frustration. Today, the lavatory block has been transformed with proper cubicles and new wash basins and baths. The £14,000 conversion was helped by public fundraising, which also bought this shower trolley for residents. The hospital insists much of this work was already in the pipeline before the highly critical report was leaked, but they admit there's still a long way to go. Operation Botley's, they say, will transform the hospital from an institution into a resource centre. 400 of the 900 residents here, those not in need of full-time medical care, will be moved back into the community, many for the first time in 40 years. Houses like these are being converted to take them, either supervised or visited regularly by trained staff. The hospital's Murray House Annex, an old Victorian workhouse, will be closed next year and its male residents transferred to the main site, where seven of the 30 villas are being improved.
With large groups moving into other community projects, we have more space, with more room. We can share the facilities around so that they will be getting much more benefit from resources and staffing.
Are you going to get more staff?
We are.
How many more do you know? I mean, it was 200 that the report called for.
We don't think we would get that. And of course, we're talking about costs sensibly. But we have recruited very well indeed. And it may surprise everyone to know we have waiting lists for staff to work in the community.
£1 million won't pay for the whole five-year programme, but staff here say it's a real start to helping the mentally handicapped lead more fulfilling lives. John Andrew in Surrey.